जी विजिबल टू यू। हेलो
आई ब्लर है सर।
एंड जस्ट शोइंग वन चार्ट टू यू, जस्ट के सीट कर चेक इट प्लीज। विजिबल ओके। जस्ट सी व्हाट आई एम सेइंग हियर। We know our aim of the practical is to determine critical speed of the shaft. Specifications of the setup. So AC motor we are using. And this is the setup we are having. At the top we are having motor. This one is shaft, the bearings, and one disc is attached at the center to the shaft. Just 1 minute. Okay, I'll just explain you first setup. This one is shaft which is rotating. The shaft is rotated by means of motor. Then you can see here, there are the housing to fix that shaft. And the shaft is fixed between two ends, one end here and other end at the bottom, you can see here. So in between one disc is fitted. And as I told you in the theory session, the disc which is attached at the shaft is having some eccentricity, means its center of gravity of this disc, this rotating disc, is not exactly at the center, but at some distance from the center. So center of gravity and the center of rotation is not at the same point, but at some having some eccentricity, and hence there will be some centrifugal force acting outward. Now I'll show you the setup for measurement of RPM. Actually, it is showing having some problem to get the RPM. But okay, this one is a RPM indicator to get the RPM, and this one is dimmer stat just to vary the current and voltage to the motor so that we can change the RPM by rotating this switch. So this is our overall setup. I'll just tell you some specifications here. So disc of size 150 mm and thickness is 4 mm. Then shaft of size 530 mm length. Length of the shaft is 530 mm and diameter is 8 mm that we are using. So this shaft we are using 530 mm length and diameter is 8 mm. Motor specifications are given: 230 volt, RPM is 1500, 1/6 HP and 1.3 ampere. These are the specifications of the setup. Now I told you we can find value of the critical speed theoretically, and it is 1350 RPM. So when we start increasing this shaft RPM, you can see now I'm going to increase the RPM. Initially it is rotating, but you can see it is not rotating smoothly. I'm going to increase some RPM slowly. You can see disc is not rotating exactly at the center. Means there are some vibrations are still are there. So you can see when the speed is omega, that is omega RPM, whatever it is less than omega C, there are some vibrations. Not that much, but there are some vibrations. As you can see, omega is less than omega C, then the outer side is having G. G is on the outer side. So there are some vibrations on the shaft rotor system. If I increase it, you can see vibrations are increasing because we are approaching to critical speed. So there are lateral vibrations. The shaft is vibrating laterally in this direction. You may note on the sound also. I'm increasing this RPM. And once I increase beyond the critical speed, you can see now when we are rotating above the critical speed, the shaft vibrations reduces. While when we are rotating at the critical speed, there are more vibrations. Now, vibrations are less as I am rotating above the critical speed. So you can actually note down the speed from this side, but actually it is not working. So it is under maintenance. Just we need to calculate the RPM. So once we calculate RPM, we come to know what is speed at which the shafts vibrate violently. So it is simple experiment to calculate the RPM, or you can say critical speed at which shafts vibrate violently. Once we note down that, we can find it experimentally as well as theoretically. So once we get repeat, we'll do it later on also. Just we need to find that range, find that RPM, at what value there is shafts vibrate violently. So I'm going to reduce the speed now. You can see when I'm reducing the speed, how RPM and vibration changes. I'm reducing it now. You can see when it is reaching critical speed, again vibration increases. I was rotating it above the critical speed. Now it is reaching critical speed, so vibration increases. You may note the sound as well as vibrations. Slowly I am reducing it now. So what you conclude from this? Whenever speed of the rotation is less than critical speed, there are some vibrations. At critical speed, there are more vibrations. But if you are rotating shaft at a speed more than critical speed or higher speed, then shaft vibrations reduces and it will run smoothly. That is what conclusion of this experiment. In order to take reading, you have to come to college. Theory, I hope you understand. So we need to shut down this.